I didn't know you were getting hit before me, you motherfucker. This is it. This guy talked me into this trip. You did. I've been telling everybody you talked me into this thing.
Yeah, you're telling everyone.
I said it's a 25th anniversary of your trips. All right, so we're going to be together for the next 16 days.
Yeah.
All right, good. You should come get drunk with us tonight.
This
thing's going to make my fucking face for the next 16 days.
So, introduction. So. Hi, I'm Nick Maturi.
Are you starting already?
Johnny Filipakis and I met in 1986. I was finishing up my graduate school work in London, and my last 2 weeks in Europe, I decided I'd spend it on a Greek island. So I met Johnny, and we hit it off immediately, doing these crazy drinks called Afghanistans, and you know, just hung out, got some sun, had some drinks, met some girls, just really had a nice time, and that was 35 years ago. So it's been a fun friendship, and so I've enjoyed it. And getting together on this trip was something John wanted to do. I was sort of reluctant at first, but I decided to go forward with it.
I'm gonna give myself about 2 days before I smash that fucking thing over his head.
From the moment we got to Kathmandu, we just knew it was gonna be just an exciting, chaotic, just crazy city, and it certainly did not disappoint. But look, Kathmandu is a poor city. It's one of the poorest countries in Asia. And you could see that on the streets. I mean, the infrastructure wasn't there. You know, you could just see that the people and you know, the kind of poverty that kind of overtakes things. We stayed. Our hotel, the Holy Himalaya, was right in the middle of downtown. And to describe it as chaotic would be an understatement. Cars, mopeds, everybody just going in every direction, not really following any real sense of structure or whatnot, just everybody kind of doing their thing. But it works. The vendors weren't hassling you to buy things. They were just nice people. I mean, we were buying things from people just because they were nice.
Somehow, we've grown.
I feel like one of those Oompa Loompas in Willy Wonka. They walked into that special room and it starts to shrink on them. All right, I'm gonna take these two. Be nice to me, all right?
How much?
I'm gonna give you $5 for both, okay? Because I like you. I'm in a rickshaw and this guy's chasing me down the street. I think it's this guy's cousin. He's trying to steal me as a customer.
He said to sell me smoke.
Yeah, for smoke.
He's trying to sell me some dope.
Dope, yeah.
Don't do drugs, just say no.
The nightlife was just as chaotic. A lot of bars, a lot of restaurants, just a lot of cool people walking around. You know, we ended up in the section of the city where there was expats. So, you know, a couple Irish bars here and there. But just walking around in the streets was what I found the most enjoyable. Me and John just walking around, you know, looking in shops and just really getting the feel for everything was a lot of fun. So we're doing some sightseeing. Where are we going first?
Monkey temple.
We're advised not to feed the monkeys.
And the first thing you see is a monkey food stand. Thursday included a trip to the monkey temple in Kathmandu, officially known as the Swayambhyath Tibetan Buddhist Temple, which is really a large Buddhist stupa way up at the top of a hill. So it takes a nice steep climb to get up there, richly decorated with prayer wheels and prayer flags. But the interesting thing, which is why they call it the monkey temple, is that there's monkeys running around everywhere, looking for food, causing havoc, you know, stealing things. Very funny just to see these animals running around all over the place.
Oh, Mani, pardon me, home. We have a tour guide who talks too much. These are the flags that they bring up to Everest. Om Mani Padme Hum.
the earthquake. So a lot of these temples actually came down. You can see there's been a lot of construction. This one, unscathed. This one, pretty good. We are in Patan Square, right? Watching. This is interesting. They're getting there fetching water, basically. Not a particular tap, which doesn't seem to be running. Can you see that thing closer?
The energy centers, the seven chakra. Any of these Eastern healing, Eastern medicine is about activating your chakra, opening your chakra. Basically understanding, you know, these chakras are different organs of your body. Different metals, they have different frequencies. And that actually corresponds to different chakra of the body.
So what are the seven chakra?
It's your brain,
yes.
Your throat, your heart, abdomen, your sexual organs, your thoughts, you know, the sixth sense.
Yes.
These seven different points, the energy points, they are, we call this chakra, but basically understanding they are these functional organs. To find the right pressure, you need to find the right speed to maintain the balanced vibration, balanced sound. So it's all about a little patience, you know, focus, and controlling the vibration is part of controlling yourself. So you create the sound of Om. So you're listening to the sound, the mental exercise, relaxation, de-stressing. But for actual meditation, you're chanting together with the Om.
But none of any powerful earthquake can completely damage this temple. It's such a very strong foundation, completely stone temple, Indian style temple architect. The first this sort of architect was originated in India, and during the time of cultural transformation we imported it, so it's known as Indian style temple architect. However, most of the temple in this architecture is quite common in Nepal, which is known as pagoda or Nepali style architect, right?
Gonna ring the bell.
And this Kathmandu Valley itself is one of the highly affected area of 2015 earthquake.
Right.
So right now when you visit this sort of UNESCO World Heritage Site monument, you can see the restoration is still going on. But those people who have, you know, lost their personal property, I mean private house, private school or whatever, they don't have.
East of the river here, the holy river, where they do cremations. These are the holy men that are hanging about, and so one, two, got a couple guys. They're all Hindu guys. All right, God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It is quite common to see such a cremation going on at any time, right? Either if you guys come early morning, at the midday evening, or even in midnight, seeing at least one cremation going on is quite common here. If we have mass death, like 2015 earthquake, you may see like 10, 20, 30 death bodies burning at the same time, but even in normal situation, you can see at least one cremation going on here, right?
So we're at the big Buddha stupa in Kathmandu. So today we're walking around, we're hanging out, and just shopping. All right, so tell them what I just saw you. Oh, you got it, nice. I thought you were gonna screw that up.
Fuck,
for sure.
You reckon?
Just keep saying it over and over again until you reach nirvana.
It means
the soul that comes from the great lotus. So essentially, it's supposed to incorporate all the sounds of the universe.
Right.
Om is the sound of the universe. So all religions have that. All religions have a state of grace. Christians have it. Buddhists call it nirvana. Oh,
deal is we have a flight tomorrow morning. He won't tell me what time it is, which means it's gonna be really early. So we're gonna eat and we're gonna go to bed. We are in Montaj. We just took an hour and a half cab ride from a little unique hotel, and now we're in this town where it's kind of a village. This village has an airport in it.
We're from Summitair and we are here at Ramitap Airport. Right now Ramitap Airport is closed due to the weather, so all the passengers are waiting for their flights. So let's have some patience and wait for the weather to clear up.
Okay, so how long does the bad weather last? It can last an hour, 2 hours?
Lukla might be.
Okay, that's right.
How long is the flight to Lukla?
Well, it's 18 minutes from here.
One way.
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
We got our boarding passes, we got our luggage, and our plane's not even on the tarmac. It's coming in from Lukla. The plane we were supposed to take just took off with some other people on it, because they got here like 10 minutes before us at the airport, so it's a little fucked up. We're out here in the mud. Our plane's not even here. I repeat, our plane's not even here. Shots, and now we're just in the main square here. Little shopping area. Back.
Little temple, I guess.
Awesome.
Ready to rumble.
Oh, good morning, everybody. This is on day two of the hike. So we're just checking out the hotel that we're in. Talking about how out of place it looks. It's almost like a palace. I like how obviously the low mountains are not gonna have any snow on them, but then behind them you got the nice peaks. Kesh, we just went by the rhododendrons. We didn't take any pictures of those.
Here, you know the peach?
The what?
Fruit peach, peach fruit.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes. Yeah,
that's my little fruit. Yeah. Yeah, beautiful tree. Sagartha.
Yeah.
National Park buffer zones. We're buying our tickets here with my main dog, Riley. What's your last name?
Payne.
Riley Payne.
I'm
glad you're not a doctor.
Yeah.
Like a Dr. Payne. That's a name you don't want to have if you're a doctor.
It was the first woman that ever summited Mount Everest.
What's her name?
The memorial statue.
Yay!
Alright, this is the first real nice shot of a peak that we've seen so far. So we're about an hour and a half outside of Lukla, and that's the first shot we've seen of a nice peak with the snow covered.
This is the writing about the mantra from the Buddhisms. So this is the Om Mane Padme Hum.
Guru, Wahe Guru, Wahe Guru. Wahe Guru, Wahe Guru.
This is our yak.
Yes.
And that's the feeder. That's the Kongma. That's the Kongse. And that's the Tangse. Tangse. These are the names. So one of the very nice ones was like Peter.
Peter is our yak.
And how did you get the name Peter?
I think they gave it to me. I wanted to call him Henry, but they said it's called Peter.
It's a bit nerdish, isn't it?
It is a little nerdy. I like him though, look at him.
Yeah, we just took a little walk from Namche Bazaar. This is the acclimatization day. So we did about a 20-minute straight uphill walk to get to Sagarmatha National Park. We're at 3,555 meters, and it is just spectacular. So you want to follow me around the hill? Just keep going. Right behind me is the most spectacular hill here. We're not even in the tall stuff yet. These are still the baby hills. So just keep that going on.
So at what height do they start using oxygen?
They start the oxygen the first camp.
All right.
Because of the, you know, they try train up there.
Yep.
And we can see the few mountains, small peaks. Tomorrow we can see, day after tomorrow we can see.
Yep.
That's the, we call the supported peaks.
Okay.
There's like a Labuche peak and island peak. They try to, you know, climb there, and then the Kumbwa Icefall is very dangerous.
Everest!
Yee yee!
That's 8,848 meters.
How do you remember that? That's great.
Oh, look!
So, after here, we go to the museum here, just for 15 minutes.
Okay!
Resam piriri, resam piriri. Sometimes uphill, sometimes downhill. Resam piriri. Tapari huni he barai na huni salai ko.
Wait a minute, I want some. With the light bulb at the door. He barai na lapati
has. Cat.
Doctor!
All right, I did a couple of low squats. I do have a little bit of a head rush right now, I gotta be honest with you. It's not like CrossFit, because we're doing it at 10,000, 11,000 feet, but that was fun. These tour guides did a nice job just giving us a little local entertainment, so God bless them. Namche is a very cool village, significant with respect to the ones that we're going to see in the future because it's the last really sizable village. Tea houses all built into the side of a hill. Just looks like a really nice place and populated. Coming into the town, it was really cool because we saw a couple of prayer wheels powered by a stream. And the town itself was actually very nice because, once again, it was sizable. So you had some really nice villages You had some nice retail shops, coffee shops, bars. So, you know, we really enjoyed it there. Namche was a cool place, and, you know, I hope to get back there at some point in my life.
Journey like 5 to 6 hours. It's called the Debuche. Everybody get phone and follow the everyone, you know, the one to each other, help each other. Okay?
Yep.
Okay.
Hooray!
Sharing is caring.
All right, so we're on day, I forget what day we're on, but we're now heading from Namche over to Dimbonche. And we're on our way. We just started out in the morning here, about 20 minutes into it. And it snowed a little bit last night, so it's been melting off the rooftops, kind of hitting us in the head as we're walking, but it's not rain. It's actually a beautiful day. Got some nice peaks going there, and there's a little bit of a snowfall last night, which is going to melt very shortly. So Johnny, get a nice shot of the valley here. It's all farmland, and you can see a nice, beautiful snowfall that came in last night. Really nice.
See the red buildings?
Yeah.
That's the checkpoint. And after that, we cross the bridge and we stop there our lunch. And after lunch, we cross that bridge again and we climb that hill and on the way to Namche. Dal Bhat Pawa, 24 hours in the mountain, no shower.
Okay, these are we're from Namche on day 5, and these are the first real yaks that we're gonna see. So here they come, and I'm excited because they are beautiful animals. With the most backpacks on him of anybody, and Prakash was telling us that these guys, while they're young, they try to make as much money as they can. They abuse their bodies and just, you know, try to eke out a living while they can still go up and down the hill. So that guy is the most weight that we've seen on a Sherpa so far. So God bless him. From Namche to Dimbonche, and we just met a bunch of English Royal Marines that are going to the summit of Mount Everest. This is Tom.
Hi.
Tom, how you doing? And 65 North is the name of their Facebook page and I guess their organization. And there's 5 guys going to the top. So say a little something. First time?
Hey, how's it going? My name's Tom. I'm one of the 5 members of the 65 Degrees North team. We are halfway through the Everest Base Camp trek. We should arrive Everest Base Camp on the 15th. And then begin our first rotation on the 19th of April, and we hope to summit middle of May.
Okay, we'll be keeping track of you.
Okay, thank
you. All right,
you.
Good luck.
Thanks.
Good. Not really. God bless you guys.
She's the good one to talk to.
Yeah, right. Thank you.
I'm so sorry for that.
That's when you give him a swift kick.
What can I tell you?
For your cat. Cat.
I forgot the sleeping bags and the room because I'm a douche. And Bishnu had to go back. No, the other stuff I wanted to leave there. Oh, okay. The other stuff I wanted to get rid of. Now where am I going? I've been trying to get rid of these clothes. Now I got them here. Maybe I'll give these clothes to these people here. They could probably use them. All right, we're getting ready to cross this bridge. Way it over.
Yeah.
Going up to Dimbonche. There's my barrel. That's not you.
Good luck.
You look just like Catalina. I'm getting my Australians mixed up. All right, ready to get on this bridge? Let's do it.
Let's do it. Ash is ready.
I'm ready. Yep.
No fear, no fear.
Conquering the fear.
We met a guy from India, Bitu, and all four of us are hanging out together. And he says, "Are you here with you? Are these your kids? Are these your children?" I said, "Yeah, all four of my kids." I said, "They could be my kids." I said, "But they're not."
Wait until you meet mom.
He's still coming.
The Tengbuche, you can see there is the beautiful old biggest monastery in the Khumbu region. When people come for the expedition, they bless you here with the monks. This is the very, very holy place.
End of day five hike, a long hike, 6 hours, 6.5 hours. And at the top of the hill, we're now at Tenboche, which is at 3880, I believe, meters above sea level. Highest I've ever been personally, myself. And at the top of the hill, there's the highest monastery, Buddhist monastery ever, so that's right behind us. I think it's from the 16th century. How they built the monastery up here, I'll never know, but up here, really nice. Just went inside, really old statues and paintings of Buddha, so really something nice to see. And now we got some snowfall. I'm not sure if you can see that, so we're up in the hills and it's snowing. And that's my buddy right there.
All right, yeah.
That's Bishnu.
That's good, mate.
Bishnu.
Yeah, we need to get going.
Oh. Wow, look at the mountains.
Whoa!
All right, Ron.
The shot.
What?
Are you videoing?
Yeah.
My grumpy face in the morning. I just got fucking screamed at by some little Nepalese lady. I'm just looking for a cup of coffee, man. But it's apparently it's too early. So I'm gonna sit here. Alright, come on, let's go take a walk outside.
So the Himalayan Social Journey team, we are heading to base camp. Today our journey was Dingbuche, 4,400 meters. So we are heading to Dingbuche. 1, 2, 3, go!
We're good? We just left Deboche. We're headed to Dingbuche pretty soon, and Ashley here is helping me fix up my snot rag. Once again, we're on our way from Deboche to Dingboche, and just sitting here with my main dog, Ashley, getting it done. Looking down, we're looking down at a beautiful river. It's gonna make you famous.
My main dog.
My main dog. There's Chelsea from Chelsea. So we got the beautiful river down here, and Johnny, you're gonna pan out, and you got a beautiful shot of Tengboche Monastery, right in the foothills of the mountains. It's just gorgeous. Amitabha, we've seen this from many angles. Mother and daughter is a translation, but we've seen it from a few different angles. But if you can zoom in on that behind us, it is just gorgeous. So, and we got a good day for it.
How are you?
Alright, yeah.
Boys?
That's the Amadablum. The mountain name is Amadablum. There was, you can see the ice. That ice was still 20 years. I'm working here, that like same, like that. But never for till now.
Okay, we just took a little tea break here in Pang Boche.
Yeah.
And we're doing a little 360, John's famous 360. I'm gonna smack him in the head any minute now with these 360s. Hey, Libis, that's a tough way to make a living. That guy's carrying plywood.
Man, we've been following him. He's just, that's a tough slug, man. That's a tough way to feed your family.
Just watching him is hurting me.
Yeah.
Physically and mentally. Jeez.
Building a, these are prayer walls. And you see these a lot. They build little mini cairns. The one behind me that we just photographed was a big one. So this is a baby one. So starting out, and then you got this range here. Everest is behind it.
We're coming into Dingboche, which this was the most beautiful walk today. Just beautiful day, just beautiful views everywhere. And we actually just got done crossing this plain called the Mountain Desert, which was right in the valley and just spectacular. Saw some sandstone coming off the hill. Saw some great little, you know, little walled temples here is what they do. Every one of them has, these are old. And every one of them has Omane Panehom. Their chants, other chants as well. And then in the distance, you'll see right along this river is the city, Dingboche. That's our destination for the last, for the next couple of nights. So it looks like more of a town. Last night we were in some like farm. And tonight we're, and we got Manesha's Indian music playing in the background. There's a little backdrop for my look here. And then that's our town for the night. Come on. Come on over here. Right? So, I mean, God, we're bringing up the rear right now. He's got music, all the Bollywood movies. He's got the soundtrack. Just listens to them endlessly. So imagining all these women dancing around and men. All right.
Yeah? Good. 89.79.
He's just had a bit of a rough sleep last night, not feeling the greatest. So the boys are just doing a few tests on him to make sure he's going to be okay for today. Pull through and we'll go for a walk today, do a bit more acclimatization, then come back down and have another night here.
Live, you know, yeah.
Live. First day.
Yeah, first day, yeah.
We're in Dingboche, and these are my friends, my Italian friends. They're from Rome. Si chiama?
Luca. Ciao.
Michela, ciao dall'Italia.
Okay, so these guys are on a little solo tour, and we've been chit-chatting all night, so they don't speak English, so I'm going to speak for them. Speak English.
How are you? Very well, thanks. What time is it? The cat's on the table. I don't know. No.
Oh, that's funny. But yeah, they both...
I think a little bit English.
All right. So
they, more.
So they both work in a hospital in Rome. They're doing a solo tour. They're just like us. They're doing base camp. It's their first time doing it. And it's been a pleasure to meet them. So we just want to say hello. Auguri. And good luck. Okay.
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 Have a good time. Enjoy your time here.
Okay. So you do speak English. I knew it. Okay. Auguri.
Ciao.
Okay. Safe travels. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Breathing is very important here. So everybody, first thing, hands in prayer position. You take a nice deep breath in. Hold it. Nice breath out. One more nice deep breath in. Hold. Breathe out. Okay, hands up the sky. Good job, just take it all in. A nice slow bend. Right to the waist, halfway. Put your hands on your knees. Let them dangle, let your head dangle. Just feel the weight of your head going right down. Come up halfway. Take a nice deep breath. Breathe it out. All the way up to the sky. Hands are prepositioned.
Climatized day, 4,700 meters. So we were heading to the Nagarjuna Hill and come back to here. 1, 2, 3, go!
How's it going, Fiona?
It's going good. It's getting my breath back.
Started our hike up to Nagarjuna Hill today. We're going to do a bit of acclimatization. We've got the group here, everyone's feeling good, we've had a good sleep. The whole group's doing well.
Whoa! Excuse me, this guy's trying to steal my job, right? But we're going up the hill. Today's acclimatization day, and we're headed back up.
1,040 meters! For the base camps, we are heading to this spot and to go to rounding. So first of all, from here to Labuche. Labuche is 4,900 meters. It's the sea level. We're staying one more night there and then base camps. All right. Today our hike is here. That's flag. A lot of people are climbing and that's what we call Nagarjuna Hill. All right. Okay, and namaste.
1,700.
And we can see this type of the monuments. We can see tomorrow on the way, there was the one place we call Tukla.
We're at the top of our acclimatization. Nagarjuna Hill. And this is the greatest view I have ever had in my life, so. We're surrounded with the two daughters, mother daughter behind us. We get some of the highest peaks and the lands behind us as well. And just all the way around. So it's just too much for the eyes to take in at once. But...
Ding buche tomorrow, la buche re sam piri ri.
Woohoo!
Altitude sickness.
All right, we're waking up on the second night in Ding Boche, and now we're heading up north to La Boche. And I just realized that our hotel room here, as lovely as it is, this little two bedroom with nothing except two blankets that got shit stains all over them. But I just realized we're in jail. Look, we got fucking barbed wire in case I want to escape
the gulag.
And John outside is looking at a potato field. Yesterday we saw some poor bastards just digging and digging and digging, making a living, digging up potato fields. But yes. All right, let me out.
Now we are in 4,400 meters. Himalayan Social Journey teams. We are heading to Labuche tonight. And tonight is 4,900 meters. And one more night in our destinations. 1, 2, 3, go!
From what I had seen and read, I knew the Himalayas were going to be beautiful and majestic and all the things that I thought they were going to be. But when I actually saw them, it was even more than that. The views got better, the hills got better. You just started to see things from a different angle.
and we had beautiful weather. And so with all that combination, we just really, really got to see the Himalayas at their most beautiful. And as you're hiking, you're surrounded, you know, by these beautiful mountains, and they're snow-capped, and you're on glaciers. And, you know, you think that after a while you'd get sick of it, but you really didn't. You walked through it. It became part of the landscape, but you never lost that fascination with these beautiful mountains.
You girls are from Athens?
We're from Athens, yes.
And you're traveling to the top of Everest, is that correct?
Yep, we will try to reach the top of the world, yeah.
So you've given me your details and we can follow you on YouTube, is that correct?
Yes, you can follow us
on our Facebook page
and Instagram.
Yes.
Because what we try to do is the seven summits. We have completed five out of seven.
Yeah.
And now we have Everest and Vinson in Antarctica.
Yes.
Hopefully, if we can make it to Everest this year, it's going to be a great success.
That's a great success. Well, we'll wish you all the best and we will monitor you.
Thank you.
Καλό ταξίδι.
Καλό ταξίδι. Πατριώτη.
And, you know, and I've been in many places where, you know, there were nice mountains and it was, you know, it was beautiful and whatnot. But this was special because we were living in the mountains. We were living amongst these beautiful, beautiful ranges. And we had guides that would tell us a little bit about each hill, you know, and what they were, what their names were, how high they were. So every day was just beautiful.
Up here for our rest point bakery cafe for our little lunch break. Another beautiful day, which is pretty lucky. Another beautiful, the scenery is just getting better and better the closer we get to the base of these mountains. It just, the presence is impressive.
Stopped here at the Tukla Pass, which is on the way. So tomorrow we're going to be at base camp. So tomorrow's a big hike. But today we're at a memorial park. Really, it's a cemetery. A memorial park. Obviously, there's no bodies here, but all memorials for people who have died on Everest. So it's a very solemn place. It's very intense. I just wanted to talk briefly, but just walking around for like the last 10, 15 minutes. Behind me is a memorial to a Sherpa who has a couple of different world records. For Mount Everest. He climbed it the fastest, he climbed it twice in 2 weeks, and then he also spent 21 hours up there with no oxygen. So just amazing. I mean, if you could feel just the shortness of breath here, to be on top of Mount Everest with no oxygen is just an incredible feat. If you follow me around this way a little bit, behind me are a number of different monuments to, I've seen one to an American, he was a Jewish fella, so there's a Star of David on his monument. There was there's an Italian guy that he has a little monument in a gold plate in Italian. There's a bunch of Chinese guys that all had the same monument. So it's a very, very solemn place. There's a lot of different monuments here. John just saw on the other side the monument to Rob Hall, who was the New Zealand expedition leader featured in the movie Everest, where a number of people died on that expedition. So a very solemn place, but a very beautiful place. In a nice valley on the hill here, so just a pleasure to be here. But it's a quiet place. It's not a place to be celebrating. But just a nice place to be looking around. Behind me is base camp for Mount Laboche, which is right behind me, and it's a very technical climb. So what this group here is going to do, and it looks like a small city there, we counted about 30 tents. They're gonna set up camp here, which they've done. They're gonna climb Mount Laboche, very technical climb, and it's a good warm up for Mount Everest. So that entire little village
I don't know when, but they're going to move that entire village over to Mount Everest Base Camp, where we're going to be tomorrow. So interesting, and I wasn't expecting it to be that big, but it's a large village that they've set up there. We're almost in Lepuche, and we're just right here. There's a nice glacier that we're walking along with a nice flowing river. And right behind me is a serious yak attack coming through, so heads up.
It was a big day.
What's that?
Cheese.
Okay. Lemon ginger?
We are heading to around 5 to 6 hours in base camps. 1, 2, 3, go!
Okay, it's Saturday the 13th, and today is game day. So we are going to Everest Base Camp. We got two. This is a kind of a two-cycle hike. We go to Gurkchup first. We drop off some bags, and then we go to base camp. Now, if the weather's nice, we could be coming back down and then going up to I forget the name of it, Atura Patur, something like that. Another side hike, but today's the day. Here's why we came. So let's do this. All right.
All right.
We're an hour into this trek from Lobuche up to base camp, and the weather is just starting to clear. So it's been really cloudy and cold this morning, but if you look behind me, you can see that these mountains are starting to smile, as Prakash just said. So it's getting really nice, and momentarily we'll have the glacier to contend with, and we'll be walking right side by side with it. So that's it for now. Over.
Oh, Gurkhan.
Gurkhan from California.
Yeah.
And hey, Dad, what's going on, brother? How you doing? Good, good. Was it all it was worth?
It's good, man. It was worth it. Yeah, okay. It's tough, but it's worth it.
Okay.
Yeah, man. You guys are gonna have a good time. Don't worry.
All right.
You're almost there.
I know. Feels all right. Good. Feels
take
good.
Care.
On our way up to Gurkchup. And we're just making the notation that it's really busy today. There's a lot of people on this trail. The owner's telling me that 2 years ago, same exact time, there was nowhere near this many people. So it's busy. There's people coming up, people coming down. So it is a packed trail. So I've got a bump behind me, and then lunch is the reward. So saddle up.
I'm from France, close to Paris. And yeah, I'm doing it alone.
This is a gutsy kid. How old are you?
27.
All right, so my daughter Leah's age almost, so that's to be admired, so congratulations. Coming into, right behind us, is our Gurkchup, where we're gonna have lunch. But even further back, we can actually see base camp from here. It's a bunch of yellow tents. And at the base of where the yellow tents are, is that's the Kumba Icefall. So everyone's heard of that. That's where a lot of danger takes place, because that's a moving glacier. So that's the Kumba Icefall. And to the northeast of that is Everest. So we can't see it yet. Got a little hiking left to do, but this is just a spectacular vista here. Now, the Kumba Icefall, if you follow my finger just a little bit, this is the entire glacier. It looks like it's rock, but it's not. Underneath it's all ice, and it's a moving glacier that extends from Everest down through this whole valley. So It's just it's a nice spot to take a picture, and it's a nice spot to look at base camp from a distance. We're at Gurkship. We just had lunch, settled in, and we're headed to base camp. And it's snowing, which is why I look like an idiot. So hopefully we'll have some views when we get over there. But right now the weather looks like it's getting worse. But we're here, and this is the end of the trek. So at least the end of the, we got to our destination. So we are on our way. In an hour and a half, we'll be there. Over. About 2 hours in from Gurkship on a bitchy little hike that's been snowing, foggy, and now it's actually really nice. The sun is coming out, and we're gonna let the Sherpa just kind of walk by. These guys have the right of way all the time. And now right over this little bump here, we're gonna have a great shot of base camp. So let's do it. Okay, we made it. Phil Lepakis and I made it to base camp after a brutal little 2 hour hike from Gurkship. And behind us is where everybody's taking photographs, including us. You got the flag and you got the Everest base camp, and it gives the elevation, 5,360 something meters. But then if you pan around here a little bit, you're gonna see behind me, there's gonna be, first of all, the weather cleared for us. It was snowing. 10 minutes ago it was snowing and it looked really shitty. So now behind me, you got a lot of tents. There's a small city set up here. So you got the yellow tents behind me. And if you pan over even a little bit more, you got the Kumba Icefall, which is just spectacular in person because it looks almost surreal. It looks like little mini mountains that are really just coming up out of everywhere. It looks really fabulous. And if you get even behind the Icefall, by the way, the Icefall is what's famous. That's what everybody knows about, the Kumba Icefall. Anybody that has to scale to the summit of Everest has to get over that. And that moves during the day. So you start out in the middle of the night, and during the day when the sun's warm, that might move 1 or 2 inches, but it changes a lot of things in the crevices, and a lot of people get hurt and die in there. But then also behind me, you got the mountains. Now, I always thought that you could see Everest from this spot. You cannot. You cannot see the Mount Everest. You can see from other places, but not from here. So anyway, this is about as good as it gets. So this is the money shot right here. So over and out. We did Everest Base Camp yesterday. We're at the Buddha Lodge and Restaurant. We had the absolute worst night's sleep, miserable all night long. Anyway, the idea of taking a chopper back to Lukla entered the scene. I started doing some wheeling and dealing, as Johnny says, and it turns out that we're gonna take a chopper out today on this beautiful day with Emmanuel, who's not feeling so well, so we're gonna jump in on the chopper with him. So with that, I'm gonna say goodbye to the group. And it's certainly been a wonderful hike. We're gonna end it with a chopper ride to Lukla, and then from Lukla over to Kathmandu. And then we'll figure it out from there. But this has been a spectacular trip. And I myself, I'm ready to go home. I've been away a long time, and I miss my family, I miss my bed, and I miss taking a shower. 10 days, no showers.
Okay, so our team, we have a separate for two teams. Now one for chopper teams, one for trekking teams, all right? So sorry for that, someone was sick, someone wants to fly. So anyway, we'll be heading from here to Feruche, 1,000 meters down. Yeah. Very good for sleep, altitude is very good. And when you sleep tonight, it's very nice. And you don't have altitude anything, okay?
Okay, let me say one thing, please.
Yes.
I just want to say this, we're leaving early. I apologize for that, but it's been a great hike.
Yeah.
Met some great people.
Yes,
and this has been really, for me, a great memory.
Mm-hmm.
Sunshine.
Yeah.
It's been my favorite.
Yeah.
And I just want to thank everybody for a really nice time. And
yes,
obviously, once we start exchanging emails, I look forward to hearing about that. Thank you very much for what you've done.
Another one was, we are 14 people, Prakash and me, 16 people. We'll do for our Facebook, who wants to make it like a grouping.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
We want to make a grouping watch.
Yep.
We are the all over the world, one of the number one teams. We'll do for Himalayan Social
Authority.
Absolutely. 1, 2, 3, go!
Yay!
Yes.
All right, so this has been our yak man for the whole week. He's a nice, nice guy. He's one of us, doesn't understand a friggin' word that we're saying, but he's been a really nice guy. Okay? Goodbye. Thank you.
We're going down with Emmanuel, so he's got a medical emergency, and we're going to jump on the flight with him, the helicopter flight. So we're going to go from Gorakhchep to Lukla. But as we're waiting for the helicopter to take us, we're getting news from Lukla that there was a plane crash. There could be some delays, so this could be a very long day.
93.
96.
What?
96.
86.
86.
Okay, how long do you think that'll take?
1.5 hours.
We have 1.5 hours before our flight's coming back.
An hour and a half.
We're at the Lukla Airport. We flew in by helicopter from Gorakhchep. Earlier today, there was a plane crash here at Lukla Airport where a plane veered off the runway, hit a helicopter, and either two or three people died. We haven't got verification of that, but that's the crash site. Just happened earlier today. The fact that this airport is open at all is a mystery to me. So,
yeah.
But the helipads are open, but the runway is not. So, unbelievable. We're in Lukla, waiting for our flight to go back to Kathmandu, and we're just taking a walk down Main Street. So, a lot of people in town here because of the plane crash. They can't go anywhere, so the runway's not working. So, everybody's doing a little shopping and just kind of killing some time. So. Anyway, nice little street. It's a beautiful day. I am so friggin' happy to be out of 5,300 meter altitude. I could actually breathe and feel the oxygen in my lungs.
Here's the headline. 3 killed, 4 injured in Nepalese plane crash near Mount Everest. At least 3 people were killed and 4 injured on Sunday after a small plane crashed into a parked helicopter during takeoff at the only airport in Nepal's Everest region. The crash occurred while the plane was belonging to Summit Air, was trying to take off from Lukla for Kathmandu. We're at this airport. You look outside, that's us. That could have been us. Our plane is coming out, our helicopter from Lukla, and now it's totally cloudy. And if we actually leave this airport, I'd be shocked. I got a feeling that shower time is starting to take over takeoff time. Within 3 minutes, the fog came in, and now fucking icicles are falling out of the sky, and thunder. All right, so anyway, we may make it to Kathmandu tonight. They gave us one shot in three at best.
I can't even speak, it's so insane. Look, a hailstorm, it cleared up, makes you look better. Oh, our helicopter's coming in now, a yellow one. This has just been the most insane travel day of my life, and I've had a lot of insane travel days.
Not anymore. No, I had the last 3 nights difficult breathing, and I tried to eat, but I keep vomiting, and I just couldn't hold anything down.
What about 9?
Yeah, around 9:30.
9:30.
When we left Korachan, and then we went to Lukla.
Oh.
We stayed in Lukla for a couple hours.
Did you saw there is like crash?
Yeah, it was so we were right there, right next to the crash. Hello, hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
All right, it's all over. Going back to my bed, my shower, my golf course, my wife, my kids. I love you, motherfucker. You're a fucking unique friend.
Nah.
I love our friendship. Goodbye, brother. See you on the other side.